my dad left, he said something I'll never forget. Life is too short to worry about.
Dan untuk itu, kerajaan memutuskan untuk melaksanakan perintah kawalan pergerakan di seluruh negara.
Malaysia has confirmed its first locally transmitted case of the novel coronavirus.
Malaysia has reported its first two COVID-19 deaths.
Turns out he was right. We should never lose hope or hide our fear behind a mask. Because we have the ultimate hope beyond the mask.
Hello, miss. Where's the face mask aisle?
It's over there. Maybe there are still some more left.
Okay, I will check that out. One, two, three. Okay. Good.
Sorry. Miss, do you have any masks left?
If there is no mask left, then we are running out of stock.
Oh.
So our new stock will be here by next week probably. Do you need plastic?
Yeah, I do need. Yeah.
Okay. Hi ma'am, yeah, this mask is for you.
Thank you, are you serious?
Yeah, I have extra anyway. Yeah.
Thank you for your kindness.
Yeah, kita jaga kita.
Thank
yeah.
you.
Have a nice day.
You too, bye.
Hey bro.
Yes sir.
This face mask is for you.
Face mask? I thought.
Yeah, I have extra anyway, it's for you.
Oh, how much do I owe you sir?
It's okay, it's for free, man. It's for you.
For free?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Student love free stuff. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Have a nice day.
Where am I? Oh! My person is an independent mom. Now I can't wait to observe her family. It has been some time now with my person. Now, after observing her, I know that she is a strong woman, an amazing wife, and a loving mother. Well, her husband can't come home yet, but she and her husband never fail to update one another about how things are going for them. She's a housewife, but because her husband received a pay cut due to the pandemic, she had to start a small business whereby she could cook all these amazing dishes and sell them to her friends and other people online. On top of that, she also takes care of her child. And may I say, she is very good at that. She is so hardworking and attentive towards her child and loved ones. Well, it has been such a pleasure observing her.
So, this is interesting. I got the student. Within the first week with my person, I can see that it was hard at first for him, adjusting to online classes and not being able to go out and even see his friends, but he seems to be doing fine now. He has made a huge effort to make every day meaningful by doing at least one workout session a day and keeping to a routine that allows him to be both productive and even have fun. I can see that he really loves studying, and at the same time, he knows how to keep himself entertained. He's quite entertaining to watch, especially when he is playing games online, and even throws his mini fits after losing. I'm glad he's a my person.
So, I got the Christian guy.
Huh.
And I thought my life with him was going to be boring. But it turns out I was wrong. Actually, my person is truly admirable. When I get home with him, I didn't know what to expect, and he put me down, started doing this thing that now I know is praying. And he was praying for his family, his friends, his job, and a lot more. And day after day, without fail, I kid you not, he calls up his parents to check on them. Oh, what a loving son. And he's always reassuring them that everything is in God's hands and that everyone will be fine. His mom, on the other hand, is always on the other line crying because of how worried she is. But my person is always reminding her that he is fine, he is healthy, work is not very stressful, and that he will take very good care of himself. Oh, and I think my person is addicted to online shopping. Somehow he receives packages almost every week. Oh, he also does this thing where he records himself singing in front of a camera. I'm not sure why he was doing that at first. I thought it was a bit weird, but now I know that it's for his church. On Wednesdays, he goes on a Zoom call with all these people, and he calls it a life group? And it's pretty cool, because they would all share about how their days have gone, their weeks, and then they would do Bible study together. Now before the call ends, they always give encouraging words, their fellowship, if I'm not mistaken, that's the word. But yeah, they'll be just hanging out, chilling out a bit with one another. Which is pretty cool.
As the lockdown continues, Diana is getting tired from all the housework and from taking care of a son all by herself. But I can see that she misses her husband so much. And she longs for the day when the three of them can spend quality time together again. But when will that be?
This has been going on for a few months. My person would only get out of his bed if his stomach starts to grow.
It's too early.
He barely even attends his online classes now. At most, he drifts into sleep with his camera off while classes are in session every morning. This is not a surprise because he stays up late at night to play games and he is barely awake for his morning classes. I guess it all came crashing down one day.
Please, 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 let me pass. Ah! I failed my exam. Now I have to repeat the subject again next semester. Aduh, how am I going to tell my mom? Jaden's call. Hey bro. Yes, I saw my result already. My result is okay lah, so. But you know lah, Valorant game is more important now. Yes. Oh yeah. How about yours, bro? How's your result? Oh wow. Wow, congratulations. Congratulations. That's good to you. Hey bro, I think I have to go now. I got some errands to do. Yeah. I'll talk to you soon, okay? Yep. Okay, bye. Thanks, bro. Oh, God. God, if you are so good and powerful, why did you even let COVID to happen? I can't stand this anymore.
Andrew thinks that his online game is more important than his study now. It seems like he has lost his youthful dream to be a successful engineer to help his family. The penny drops for him when he receives a phone call from his dad.
My person has always been the person everyone goes to unload all their problems and get advice from, too. Him having to juggle work, family, and church, I can see him losing himself in the sea of people who rely on him and depend on him to be the strong one, the one that has to always be okay and ready to listen to their worries and their problems. And I feel like even when he's not wearing me, his mask, he's still wearing a mask, fooling everyone into thinking that he's fine, so that they don't need to worry about him, because he feels as though his problems are not worth listening to, so he bottles it all up inside. And now I can see him cracking bit by bit. But the final blow was when he received heartbreaking news from home.
So exhausted. I feel like I'm taking care of many people, but I hope there's someone else looking after me. Oh, Mom is calling me now. Hi, Mom. How are you doing? How's everyone back home? Is Dad still hiking every week like he usually does? Haha. What? No way. When did he do the COVID test? Where did he get the virus from? Is anyone else back home affected too? He started having symptoms 3 days ago. Why didn't you tell me earlier? You know of his lung problems. Is he gonna be okay? Oh gosh. Did the KKM took him to the quarantine center? What? He's in the ICU now. Very serious. Wait a minute. What?
Hi, babe. Diana finally calls her husband. She finds the courage to tell him about all her struggles. She stopped pretending to be a supermom in front of her husband and stopped depending on her own strength. Her husband reminded her of how much he truly loves her and that they would surrender all their struggles into God's hands. He reminded her again of their wedding vows that he will be with her through thick and thin, no matter what the circumstances are.
But no matter what, I still love you and I long for the day till we meet again.
Honey, just by sharing my problem off my chest, I feel a lot better now.
Then I make up to you with what I can. Spending time with our family is all I ever wanted after this pandemic is over, yeah?
Oh, thank you, honey, for comforting me.
Oh, I should have done this more often. I remember the verse in Joshua 34, verse 15. It says, "But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord, honey. I just want you to know that, even without me by your side, God will always accompany us in our daily life and lift us up when we are weak. We just depend on Him, yeah?"
Amen. All right.
Andrew's dad calls him from Kampung when he gets a good reception to call from a nearby hill. He reminds Andrew that the Kampung people always talk about him being the first person from the village to attend university. They can't wait to all come for his graduation. Hearing this, Andrew feels sad for not giving his best effort in his study, but he blames it all on the lockdown and God for not caring about him anymore. He finds excuses and decides to pull himself up with his own effort. But will this be enough?
And now I have to repeat my semesters again. I just feel like life is so unfair to me right now. I'm still young and I have a whole new future ahead of me. But I feel like God does not even care about me. I can't go out. I can't see my friends. I can't even go to the gym. If God really cares about us, then why is COVID-19 is even happening in this world?
My boy, regardless of your result, we are still proud of you. Your mother, your siblings, and I back home never stop to pray for your well-being. Despite us being very far apart, we know that God's protection is always upon you. And we have faith that you will be strengthened through Christ Jesus. Especially during this pandemic, yeah? Let me share a Bible verse with you, Isaiah 40, verse 31 says, strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord.
Not this again.
So son, whenever you're feeling weak and you can't talk to us, call out to God and ask for His strength and comfort.
A few days later, Ian received the news that his dad had passed away because of COVID. Ian and his family could not even attend the burial of their own father. It was exhausting for him both emotionally and physically. Will he be able to find the true hope beyond the mask?
Lord, I know that everything is beautiful in its own time, because you have said so in Ecclesiastes 3. Forgive me, Lord, for I have sinned. Forgive me, for I have doubts. I believe that now it's time for me to continue my dad's faith legacy, to glorify your name in my life, using the gifts you've given me. Oh Lord, give me strength and consolation to overcome this grief. You are my rock and my refuge, and all of my life is to glorify your name. I've promised my dad to live my life for God's purpose. So lead me, Lord, to the right path. Thank you, Lord, for sending your Holy Spirit to strengthen me and for showing your love on the cross for us. You are my hope in the troubled sea. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
He is my light, my strength, my soul. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the
faces. Hey, good morning. Are you the delivery volunteer? Yes, I have finished cooking this delicious fried rice for the families living in Kampung Mahiba. Alright, I will bring them to you outside. Thank you. See you soon. Bye.
Here in the love of Christ I stand.
Hey sir, are you the delivery volunteer?
Oh yes, I am. My name is Ian and I'll be driving the food from house to house today.
Wow, sounds good. You look familiar though.
Familiar?
Yeah. Are you the guy from the pharmacy?
Pharmacy?
Yes.
Oh yes, you're the lady who's
keeping the
food.
Yeah.
Oh, how have you been keeping during this lockdown?
Oh, not bad.
You know, I love to help people who need during this lockdown.
Yeah, I agree with you. We need to help each other who are struggling during this lockdown. Our nation is crying out.
Yeah.
Let me take the food from you. Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Oh, your son must be like very grateful to have a mom like you.
Yes.
And your husband, oh, I can't wait to see him next time.
Me too.
Hey bro.
Yeah?
Do you remember me?
Yeah, I think I remember you. You're the guy from the pharmacy, right?
Yes, that's me. And you are the lady from the pharmacy, right?
Yes, I am. Wow, good memory. You must be a bright student.
Yeah. Nah, actually, I can't forget when I receive free stuff. Students love free stuff, by the way.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I can't believe we all meet meet you again.
I know, right? God works in such mysterious ways.
That's for sure. Mysterious ways, right? But these days, I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul.
Oh, bro, why do you say that? But I like that quote from Invictus.
Actually, if you see nowadays, there's so many things have changed throughout this freaking pandemic. A lot of life has been put on hold. We are being locked up like a caged animals. People are losing their jobs. Some even losing their life. Why? Because we all are waiting for that mysterious God to do something. So my opinion here is, why don't we, as the most intelligent species in this planet, write our own path and create our own decisions? Are you guys agree?
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that you're struggling during this pandemic, bro. But if you're ever free, we should hang out and grab a coffee and we can talk about our pandemic life. Man-to-man talk, yeah?
Yeah.
Or you guys can come to my house. I can cook homemade fried rice.
Oh,
yes.
I'm down for anything, guys. As long as it's not related to gospel, you know. I've heard enough of it.
Ooh, we'll try our best. Anyway, we're delivering this food to the white flag houses. Do you want to help us out?
No thanks, guys, because I gotta go and hang out with my friends after this.
No worries, bro. Take care and God bless you.
Alright, guys.
Bye.
Nice to meet you again, bro. Bye. Bye. Here in the power of Christ, I'll stand.
Come on, give a lot of praise. Everybody, call. You can do better, louder. Come on, thank the team. All right. Awesome.